Hi, my name is Nadia. I am currently a sophomore at NAU, enrolled in ESC 280 with Dr. Lanneman. For my position video, I will be talking about sound. What do I mean by sound? Is the lack of sound. So I am going to be discussing students who have a hearing impairment or who are just 100% deaf, whichever one personally prefers. I've discovered that within my research. Within my research, I also stumbled upon a TED Talk by Christine Sun Kim called The Enchanting Music of Sign Language. I thought that this TED Talk was really impactful because she talked about how sign language or being deaf is not the lack of sound, but rather an obscure sound. And she compared this to using a piano within the musical world. So the symbol for piano is a P, and within that P, you can have infinite numbers of P's within the music and the composite. However, you will never be able to truly achieve silence. And so that is what she describes being deaf or not hearing actual sound is, as an obscure sound with multiple pianos. And I thought that was a really interesting way to look at it, just because most people do not see sound within a deaf student as something that is there. They kind of see that it's gone, the lack of. So I thought that was really interesting. Sun Kim also stated how sound is a part of her everyday life. What she means by this is how she responds to sound, how she learns about sound, and how others treat sound. So she learned that how others behave to a slamming door is not necessarily always the way to shut a door. She also learned how to not eat potato chips that loudly when they come out of the bag, because it does amplify sound. She compares others to those who hear as amplifying the sound for her. I thought that that was a really amazing way to go ahead and look at it, just because sound is not just what we hear, it's also what we see. For example, if someone is smiling, we can assume that their voice is in a high-pitched, happy tone. And if someone is crying, we can assume that they're sad and that they may not speaking. And so that's something that's really cool about sound etiquette is what she called it, just because I had never learned about that. And I believe that this is really important because this sound etiquette can really be used within the classroom. That way other students and other teachers can learn how to best enhance and enable that student to have a least restrictive environment. And I think that's just a beautiful thing. So thank you, and that is all I have.